Hi guys, I had the cable arrive for this, so I thought I might as well do a little, I don't know what you'd call it, walk around. It's a Dell Latitude CPX. Let's turn it over. It's got Microsoft Windows 98 second edition COA sticker on it, and all the other guff that comes with it. Model number PPX, input 20 volts, 3.5 amps, Latitude C, family ref number 99080, www.dell.com, and I paid £2, £2 British, which would be about $3.50, $4 in US dollars, something like that. So I didn't expect it to work. I got it from a car boot sale, which is similar to a flea market. Actually, I don't actually see what the difference is, to be honest. I don't think there is any difference. But anyway, I wasn't actually expecting to get it home and to power it up and for it to work, but it did. So I, well, it didn't boot, but it did turn on and power up fine. So I reinstalled Windows 98 SE on it, and away it went. So, just give you a little look on here. This has got choice of mice on here. It's got the little button, I've forgotten what they call it now, track button thing, which I personally prefer to use over touchpads. I hate touchpads. Don't like them, never have done, probably never will. And it's also got the two sets of buttons as well. Yeah, have a look around the edge, shall we? See what sockets and things it's got. On the front, we've got... I should think that's the battery. Floppy disk drive, which it came with. On this side, we've got mic in, headphones, line in, TV out, and a couple of vents, and a speaker, the broken... thingy on the back. On the back we have a fan, VGA, serial, I presume that is for a docking station connector, one USB port, socket for either a keyboard or mouse, serial interface I believe that is. And it's got this, which I believe is the infrared looking at it, but it looks like the lens has fallen off. And AC, or the DC input. We've got, actually looks like two expansion slots here. That's the hard drive, and that is it. And another speaker on this side. Underneath this cover, which I don't think it's got a screw in it. That's the memory cover. So... shall we turn on? I'm just going to stand you there for a moment. When I plug in power, I'm actually organised for once. Plug that in. Right, we have the battery light. Now, I haven't actually unboxed the cable yet, but while that is booting, I'll just stand you there while I open the box. Ooh. Don't remember beeping like that before. What does that say? Invalid something or other. I'm just going to press F1. Can't be bothered. Oh, it looks like I didn't shut it down properly last time. Wasn't expecting that. This is where I find this is probably the wrong cable. But again, for the price, I'm not going to complain, even if it is wrong. But I won't know because I can't unwrap it. The eBay seller's done a good job of protecting the ends, so I'll give him credit there. That's definite positive feedback. Right, that's one end. Attention, static sensitive. I can't imagine that these plugs are static sensitive. Because there's nothing in them but wires. Let me in. There we go. We're in. There's a great way up to put this. I think along that one. There we go, it is the correct cable! Woohoo! So, I've just got to plug that in on the back. So we'll find out in this video if that actually works as well. Should do, because this CD player works on in there, because it's got a hot swappable bay there. And that CD-ROM drive was in there. Not originally, it didn't come with it originally. I put it in there so I could install Windows 98 on here. So I'm just going to log in. I don't remember what the password was. It's the same on all of them. Windows has updated your clock. I'm not too fussed about the clock. It's actually about an hour, 2 hours. Nearly 4 hours slow. There is no Ethernet port on this, so or dial-up modem actually, I've just realised, so I'm not actually sure how you'd get online with it. Okay, so it's booted up. I'm just going to turn it towards me, so I can plug in here it doing something. It's popped out. I do believe it is working. I haven't got a disc or anything, I'm just shoving it on myself. Nothing came up on screen though. I don't know if you noticed that, but nothing came up on screen. Put a disc in. Yeah, no. Let's go into in there. This is new to me, so we'll try and reboot. Knowing what Windows 98 is like, I may have to reboot it and I might recognise it. Might just click shut down, didn't I? Not reboot. Screw that in so it's a nice good connection. Okay, plug in. Initiate drive 1 sync failure. Bypass, but it won't. Damn. still not there. Good. Neptune, come on. Pentium 3, 500 megahertz. Level 2 cache, 256 kilobytes. System memory, 128 megabytes. Video memory, 8 megabytes. Ooh. The audio controller is an ESS Maestro 2E. Primary hard drive, 12,069 megabytes. That'd be 12 gigabytes, wouldn't it? Diskette drive A, modular bay. Diskette drive B, parallel port. So it's not swap it. Well, it's recognizing it there, so what am I not doing right on? Time is wrong. Might as well set that while I'm here. What have I got to do, tab? Controls? Ah, I see. There we go. Certainly not January. Oh yeah, it is actually January, isn't it? Mm. Not the 3rd, though. Is 13th. Mm. It's definitely not 19-8. There we go. That's, so if I go Alt P, we can change page. Diskette drive, internal hard drive. That's boot order. Well, it's recognizing it. That's usually F10 escape. Right, so I'll do, I'm going to control panel for a minute. Intervesting. Maybe because I'm looking in completely the wrong place. Maybe I need to look elsewhere. Mm. show up on the cruise. Punch the mouse pad, get it to do anything? No. Internet options, that's no good. For the Windows 98 disk. Let's soon see if this is going to work. I'm going to have to swap it.
Yep.
Then I have to swap it. Hot swappable destroys. This is all good fun, isn't it? Right. Just shut down for a minute. Reboot and we'll try it this way round. I've got to try and be careful not to knock you. Start giving me that bollocks. Why is that coming up as incorrect? I know for a fact that's the correct password. This time. So how come the floppy disk worked, not the bleeding CD drive? Something it didn't like because it's crushed. Plug the CD drive in out of its caddy. Let's see if we can get any luck this time. See if the password's going to work. I don't know why the password has stopped working. Work just reason it didn't. It's not showing up the CD drive. Only if I plug it in. Oh well. We No, it works. I'll just have to swap it around and use an external floppy disk drive, that's all. But yeah, kind of sort of works.
So,
let that power down. Do that. Unplug that. Unplug that so I don't bust that. Take out the disk. Floppy disk drive doesn't want to remove that. Come on. There we go. Put CD drive in. So. Seems to work fine this way around. Wonder why. There we go. Cable for it, at least. There we go. Unfortunately, the CD-ROM drive doesn't want to work via that. Well, the laptop doesn't want to pick it up, but it'll pick up the floppy disk drive for some reason. I'm not sure why. Never mind. I'm sure there's a reason there somewhere that I'm unaware of, but at least we know that technically the bay and the cable does work, because it works through the floppy disk drive. So, for now, I'll leave the CD-ROM drive installed on the laptop. It's the best option, I think. So, thanks for watching. If you like the video, and don't forget to hit the like button, please. And thank you, and subscribe if you want to see more videos, and I'll talk to you again soon.